Dear Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, to be able to meet in this place today. Lord, let us all realize today that we are standing on holy ground. Lord, also let us understand, let us also realize, Lord, it's not just because it's the church, but everywhere that we stand for you is holy ground. Lord, this is Sabbath day. This is your day. I'm so thankful for the people that are here today to honor your name. And Lord, everybody know here, please, that it's all to glorify you. It's not about me. It's not about Sister Sue. It's not about Brother Albert. It's not about any of us here. It's all about you. As the picture of you is above me on this pulpit today, Lord, all the credit, all the glory, all the praise, all the worship goes to you. And Lord, we give you all today. We surrender all. We thank you for all that you do in Jesus' name. If everybody would just please say,
amen.
Before you sit down, turn around and say good morning to your neighbor. Good morning to everybody. Amen. Wow. And give your grace a rest. Raise your hands to the one you love the best. Then shake hands with the one hereby and greet them with a smile. Now, don't you feel better? God's good. Amen. Well, I don't know what you come expecting today, but I come expecting to hear a good word from God. Amen. I know God is on the throne and God is ready to do something in the place today, because you know what? God is steadily opening the eyes of the lost. God is steadily on the throne. God is in control of your life if you'll just let him be today. Well, pick up your mat. I could stop right now and you'd be lost, wouldn't you? But you know what? Jesus did miracles.
Amen.
Now, I want you to know something before we get going on this sermon this morning. Jesus worked out in the wilderness. He went through little towns. He went through colonies. He walked and walked and walked and walked, right? And he would heal people. And you know, some would think nothing of it. Can you believe that? Some would think nothing of it. Some would be happy. Some would be excited. Some would be whatever. You know what? We have them kinds in the church today. Whatever. We got some that get excited. We got some that's happy. We got some that, oh, God, move me if you can. But don't we? I imagine all churches have some of them kinds today. But Sister Barbara on this side, Sister Kay on this side, wants to hand each and every one of you something this morning. And after they give them all handed out, then I'm going to tell you what you're going to do with them. For right now, I just want you to take it, hold it, and don't worry about what it is, okay? Because God's in control. And please don't blow your nose on that, okay? There is boxes of Kleenexes there, so please don't blow your nose on that. Amen? There's Kleenexes. Amen? Amen. I want to make sure everybody's got one. Well, I see some of you open them up, seeing if there's any money hidden there, huh? There's not. That's your mat, Brother Danny. You hang on to that now. Don't blow your nose on that. Don't be coughing on your mats this morning, okay? Good Kleenexes. As these girls are handing out your mat this morning, as you can see up here on the board this morning, pick up your mat. But for now, I just want you to hold on to that till I know that everybody has one and everybody is focused in. Amen. You know, guys, God was a miracle worker. And I want to give you some FYI this morning. Do you know what that is? Choir, do you know what that is? For your information. Hey, they haven't drowned yet, Brother Danny. God's good, isn't he? For your information, I want you to realize something, that today is Sabbath day. Today is the day that the Lord has made to rest, to worship him, to praise him. But I want to tell you something before I get started on this sermon this morning. This particular sermon that I've got for you today, Jesus was out healing on the Sabbath day. Now, that's a whole other sermon to itself. I haven't even built that one yet. Amen. That's a whole other one to itself. But I want you to recall the importance of what we have today. For your information, this miracle was done on Sabbath day. These miracles was done on a Sunday, which would need to be a whole different story, a whole different sermon. So we're going to forget that part right now. We're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about the Sabbath day. Everybody got your placemats? Lay them on the floor in front of you now. Lay them on the floor in front of you. I just did that so nobody blow their nose on them. Pick up your mat. Well, I want to tell you it's good to be in the house of the Lord today. Sister Sue and I truly appreciate each and every one of you being here. But do you have your Bibles with you this morning? If you do, okay. If you don't, okay. It's up here on the board. Can everybody see these words up here this morning? If not, come up here and let me pray for your eyesight, okay? Let's go. This is my sword. This is my protection. This is my instructions. This is my Bible, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Now give him a hand this morning, amen? I want to get John 5, 6 up there. They're quick back there this morning. I want you to see what this says. When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time, in that case, he said unto him, wilt thou be made whole? Now, I want us to notice something here, my friends. Jesus asked this man, would you like to get well? Let me tell you something. Let us know that Jesus already knew about this man because Jesus knows all. Amen? We're going to talk spiritually of how Jesus would go out and heal people. But now, do you believe this morning? God can not only touch the infirmities of your body, he can also touch your spiritual life today. Do you know that God can open the eyes of the lost? Do you know that God can work miracles in your life today? But you can't be one of these. Move me if you can. You have to be a willing vessel, okay? Is everybody in here today a willing vessel? Does everybody know that God loves you tremendously? Sister Henry taught in Sunday school this morning about how he died on that old cross. And she was talking about how she would just look at that cross and tell and see the agony, the pain. Hey, my guys, my friends this morning, he was human. He wasn't a robot. He wasn't the bionic man. He was real, like you and I. He had a real beard. He had real hair. He had real feelings. But they run him through torture and torture and torture. At any time, Jesus could have said, whoa, I can't take it anymore. But why did he do that? He died for our sins. He died so that we could have grace and mercy of the Father. So in saying that this morning, I want you to realize how much God really does love you. In John 2, 23 and 24, I want to read that to you so we'll kind of get a head start here this morning. It's up on the board. Now, when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover, in the feast day, many believed in his name when they saw the miracles which he did. But Jesus did not commit himself unto them because he knew all men. Now, let me explain what that's talking about this morning. John noted in this book that man had been ill. We're going to talk about one certain guy here in a minute that was ill for 38 years. Now, you know what, my friends? We hurt for 38 minutes sometimes, and we think we're about to die. There was people back in that day, as there is today, that suffer with many, many pains during the day. There is people right now that would love to be in church this morning but cannot get out of bed. Where's their healing? Where's their belief? Where's their faith? Do you have faith this morning? Do you have belief this morning? And do you believe that God is still a miracle-working God? Do you believe this morning that God can still touch you from the top of your head to the soles of your feet? He can open your eyes. He can make you realize this morning. But you have to be a willing vessel. You're going to hear me say that quite a bit because I think you need to be reminded of it. See, I think some of us just sit around and sometimes say, well, I wonder why God don't touch me. I wonder why God don't do anything for me. Well, let me go ahead and step on your toes this morning. What have you done for God?
Amen.
Do you acknowledge God? Do you even bless your food that God give you? Did anybody remember to breathe last night while you was asleep? Yeah, nobody lies this morning in this place, do they? No, you didn't remember to breathe. God breathed for you. And God says, I love you. God says, I am not done with you till I say I'm done with you. You know, we're all on a mission. Do you believe that? We're all on a journey. We all have a purpose. God has a plan for each and every one of us. I think I put it in the bulletin today. Are you through with your missions? Are you through with your journeys? Apparently not. You're still alive. You ever thought of it that way? See, God has things for us to do. God wants us to do things for Him. Amen? Now, in saying this morning, I want to get into the sermon now because we have things that we want to talk about. I want to talk about not only the physical healings that God can do, I also want to talk about the spiritual healing that God can do in this church today. God can only do this by faith and obedience out of you. Some of you's looking at me like I didn't know I was going to school today. Well, here's the deal, guys. Here's the plan that God has for us. God says, I've given you faith. God says, I've told you how to work on your obedience. God said, I've told you how to work on your willingness. God said, I've told you how to do this and do this and do this and do that. So if we're faithful this morning, if we have faith that there really is a God, if we have faith this morning that our God can really touch our needs, you're going to get something a little bit later out of the class. You see your mats laying in front of you? Now I want you to visualize these mats that are on the floor. I want you to visualize your body laying on that, spiritually dead.
I need a bigger one.
Well, it's funny that you say that. This wasn't even planned. It's funny that you say this. Brother Bobby, Pastor Scotty, come here. Get on your mats this morning. Don't go to sleep, Brother Bobby. Go over here.
Oh, I get up here.
Hang on, Brother Bobby. I'm going to get you over here. That way we got the church to help pick you up when it's time to get up, okay? In case you can't get up too good. Brother Bobby said, this might be real. Once I get down, I can't get up. He went to sleep. Now, I want you to look at something. I want you to take note of something this morning. When people want a healing from God, some people look like they're ready. Some looks like, wow, really? Look at this guy here. He looks like he could care at least, right? But then you got this other fellow here. Boy, he's smiling. He's kind of interested in what's going on. So we might have some hope here this morning. I'm not sure yet, okay? I don't know. Man, you pitiful looking. I don't believe I could have picked anybody else any better than Brother Bobby. He looks pretty bored up there this morning, amen? By the way, that horse tied to the bar out there, that's his. That's Brother Bobby's. Jesus would walk around, and Jesus would say, you know what? He would not commit who he was. You know, a lot of people looked alike back then. Do you agree? Some of you look like me this morning. Don't go to gagging yet. Amen? But aren't we all made in God's image? And Jesus would walk around the land, and Jesus would walk through the countrysides, and some people wouldn't even know who he was. Am I right? You don't think Jesus walked around and said, hey, I'm Jesus. Hey, I'm Jesus. Hey, I'm the Father's Son. I'm special. Did he do that?
Nope.
Why did he not do that? Because there's no pride in him. He is human like you and I this morning. Well, I totally believe that on this one Sabbath day that Jesus was walking around, and he goes and he sees this poor old guy laying here. He's been laying here for 30-something years. And he's thinking, wow, what a pitiful sight. I imagine he's praying, don't you? And I imagine he's thinking. I imagine he's talking to the Father. How many of you in here today know that we have to talk to the Father? Amen. And how many of you know today that Jesus has a straight connection with the Father? Amen. And do all of you realize today that you must go through Jesus to get to the Father? Why is that? Well, you remember what we was telling you about the cross? You remember how I said that Jesus died for each and every one of us? And God said they have to go through you. See, God, Jesus, is our comforter this morning. Do you believe that? Jesus is our main line to God. Some of you is thinking, yeah, intercessor, that's good. Some of you is thinking this morning, well, I can't seem to get through to God. Well, maybe you're not quite doing it the right way. I want you to know this morning that each and every person in this place is capable of praying. Every single one of you, because if I remember correctly, I heard every one of you talking earlier. Every one of you's got a voice. I know that. Some's quieter than others. Some's louder than others. But here's my point. You have a voice box. You can talk to your friends. You can talk to your spouse. You can talk to your neighbors. At least I hope they do. And you can talk to this one and you can talk to that one. But Pastor, I don't know how to pray. Pray. Talk to him. Now, when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover in the feast day, many believed in his name when they saw the miracles which he did. I take out of that that some believed and some didn't. I totally believe it's still the same way today. Now, here Jesus is as Jesus. You know, we talk about the disciples sometimes. They're with Jesus. The Bible tells us that sometimes we have more belief than the disciples did. But why? We got to have faith. I'm sure Jesus is walking by this guy and he said, would you like to be healed, buddy? Belief. Not much belief there, is it? I don't know about you, but if I'd been Jesus, I said, well, whatever. Don't sound like you got much faith to me. I better ask the Father to give you some more faith. But that's Jesus. Jesus said, now, brother, now, son, would you like to be healed? Listen, he's making all kinds of excuses. Mumble, grumble. Well, I can't do this. I can't do that. You can't do this. I can't do that. How come all of you's looking at me like that? Because you make excuses, too. Should I go ask the choir? I had enough answers, huh? Yep. You know, guys, we are known for making excuses. Am I right? We are known. Look at him. I'm trying to heal him. He's up there just a moaning and a groaning and talking about excuses. Sister Emily, that's how they was. That's how people was. And that's how people is today. Does everybody agree that the Lord is coming soon? Amen. Where do you want your mat? You want it still on the floor?
No.
Or do you want it to?
It's going up with me.
Yep. You want to pick up your mat. Well, I feel like some will pick up their mats. I feel like some will lay on their mats. And I feel like some will just ignore their mats. But Jesus did not commit himself unto them because he knew all men. Now, do you think Jesus knew that he was going to run into this situation today? You better believe it. We have to let go, and we have to let God, as I tell all of you all the time, of the excuses and the problems and the issues that we have. How do we do that? Does anybody realize today that that's hard to do if you don't use God? Problems, situations, issues, they're kind of like belly buttons. We all got one. We at least got one. Am I right, Brother Albert? We at least got one. Well, that's putting it nicely. I imagine some of us got more than them, don't we? But Jesus would walk around and say, I need to do a miracle. You remember the parable of Legion? You remember that? Jesus released all them demons. He showed victory to many people. Jesus told Legion, go home and tell all your friends you are healed. You are a new man. God used a herd of pigs, amen? God used swine and had them to jump off the cliff because they was full of demons. Anybody's going home to eat pork chops today, they done changed their mind. But he had all them pigs jump off that cliff and all them demons was gone. See? Even you and I can do that. Do you believe that? But where's our faith? Do we have enough faith to do that? Do we have enough confidence to do that? Do we have enough trust in God to do that? Now, brother, I want to heal you this morning. How long have you been laying there?
Half
your life.
Yeah.
Well, it looks like a long time, doesn't it? You tired of laying there?
Yeah, I guess.
You want to get up and do something?
If I could.
I could. Do you have faith today?
Well, I try.
Do you have belief, brother?
Yeah.
See, you got to have belief. Okay. Well, I want you to get up because I want you to be healed. Pick up your mat. Take that back with you. Now, my illustration here this morning is, that was kind of boring, wasn't it? Yep. You weren't supposed to agree. Was that boring, Sister Crystal?
No.
Yeah.
Here's my point this morning. Here's my point. God tries to touch us. God tries to heal us. God tries to get us up to do something. But we just sit here like lumps on a log. And then when things come down, well, God! Oh, God, where you at? Right here. Do you know this morning that God is reaching down like this to you?
Amen.
But do you know this? He's not going to grab you by the collar. He's not going to jerk you up. He's not going to grab you by the head of the hair. He's not going to shake you. He's not going to say, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Because God is an awesome God. You see that brother back there? Well, at least he picked up his mat. I don't know what he's going to do with it, but he picked it up. I want you this morning to have the excitement to know that when God moves in your life, I don't want you to be a bore like he was this morning. I don't want you to be a drag. I don't want you to be like, whatever, because God says I'm real. God says I can touch you. God says I can bring you out of any situation. God says I can work miracles in your life. This is Sabbath day. Jesus healed on the Sabbath day. So guess what? Jesus is in the place today. He says, I'm going to heal you of your infirmities. Now, don't let us forget. We got to have faith. We got to have obedience. How about the word trust? We got to have trust. I want us to be on fire for God. Do you remember when some people first got saved? Yay! Man, they was doing hallelujah. They was running all around the church. They just couldn't wait till next time, good church. And I'm telling you, about three services later, here they are. More like this. The preacher, which is me, look back there and go, golly, woo! Man, where'd that Holy Ghost went, huh? Pastor Scotty goes back here and bumps the air conditioner up to 60 where I can just see some chills in the place. But I want the Holy Spirit chills in this place. Amen? Oh, God, help us. Pick up your mat. Not yet. Not yet. Look at all of you bending over. She's getting a drink of water. Boy, that was a good one, Sister Kay. Oh, it's true. Okay. As long as it's true, that's all that matters. Do I get any more scriptures, Sister Monica? Okay, I figured you'd say yes. What are they? This is also in John 5:40. And ye will not come to me that ye might have life. Do you realize today that we have to go to the throne of God to have life? Do you realize that here today? Another thing. Here's how we should act when God touches us. When Jesus walks in our life, when the Lord passes you by And he stops. You know what? Do you feel like the Lord's walking all over this planet? He's walking all over this planet. He's looking. He knows everything you're doing. He knows everything you're thinking. Oh, boy, I see some worried people out here now. He knows everything that you're thinking about, what you're going to do later today. Amen? But God says, you know what? You have to be peculiar. And once you leave this church today, you'll know what peculiar means. Amen? You have to be peculiar. You have to be different. You have to be in the class that God wants you to be in. Why? Is that special? Yes, there is. See, it's special to be a saint of God. This is how we should act. When Jesus walks by and he says, brother, I want to heal you. Sister, I see you. I want to take care of you. But when he walks by, brother, you okay? Are you hurting?
I would like to be healed.
You would like to be healed. When? Tomorrow?
Today. As soon as possible.
Does anybody else want that today? Amen. Now see, God says he's going to touch us in a special way. God says that he would open the eyes of everybody. My Bible tells me that every name shall hear the name of Jesus. My Bible tells me that every knee shall bow. My Bible tells me every ear shall hear. All of you's got a pair of them, I think. Can't see yours, brother. All that hair. Brother, what's your name?
Brother Scotty.
I knew that. I just wanted to see if you knew that. Come on, it's time to be healed. Pick up your mat, brother. Pick up your mat and run and show the church how excited you are.
He can heal anybody. He can heal anybody.
He can heal. Some of you excited, some of you embarrassed, some of you like, wow, what kind of place is this?
Wonderful.
They drown. I hope you got something out of this today. See, when the Lord moves in your life, he don't want you to look like this. See, I believe God wants us to be happy. I believe God wants us to be cheerful. Do we go through things, my friends? Yeah. The Bible does not tell me anywhere that if I would become a Christian, my life would be a bed of roses. Does it tell you that? Isn't there thorns and roses? Ooh, them hurt. See, we get hurt with them. I talk about the valley. I talk about the mountain a lot. It's nice to be on top of the mountaintop, isn't it? I mean, you feel like you're up high. You feel like everything is going good. You feel good. Your health is good. You're in a good mood. You're in a good spirit today. But, oh, my, we forget who God is sometimes. So the Lord says, ploop, kicks you down to the valley. And, boy, when we down in the valley, hey, God, where you at? Hey, Lord, where you at? I need you. Lord, I need you today. I need you to help me. Help us all with the problems that we got. Help us with the, what's the word I'm trying to look for? Help us with doubt.
Amen.
See, even in the church houses today, there is doubt. Do you believe that? Even in the church house. I'm telling you now, my friends, myself, Sister Sue, Pastor Scotty, you're going to hear the real stuff here. Amen. You're going to hear the real meat of God. You're going to hear the concrete evidence of what Jesus can do in your life. And I do not want doubt, because to me, doubt is a bad spirit in the church. And you know what? Doubt has to go. So I'm thankful today that you know who your Father is. I'm thankful today that you can praise Him. I'm thankful that now you can even pray to Him. You can talk to Him in the name of Jesus. Here's another thing I want the church to know today. God just told me to tell you this. Get off your negativity. Sunday Smiles just left. Get off your negativity. God says, as we would say it, I ain't negative. He's not negative. Everything about God is positive. Everything about God is light. Now, some of you don't know this, but there's a few things that God can't do. Don't look back. You ain't. He can't lie. He can't be in darkness. He's not going to get to you. And he's not going to hate you. Now, let me ask this question today. Does everybody realize that there is a devil? We don't like him. Boy, I know sometimes we get out there and we have problems with people. Man, you want to say all kinds of things. You want to chop their head off and spit down their throat, but you can't do that. Amen. And don't go home and kill their cat or their dog either, because that's just about as bad. Amen. But do you know today that God says he has a way for us to get around all these things?
Right.
By prayer, yep. By fasting, by going to church, by reading the word. God says, I've got you. God says, I've got you back. Amen. Does God have your back today? John described the people as important, blind, lame, and paralyzed. Some of you has been paralyzed in your spiritual walk with God. Some of you has been lame. Some of you has been excited about it. I want us to be excited about what the things that God has for us. God says your life has only just begun. But do you remember, for the ones that's been saved today, do you remember the day you got saved, you was on fire? I mean, you was wound up for God. I've had people come to me and say, why don't we have a, how come there's no revivals around here? You want to know the truth? The church is going to have to start a revival. We got to have revival in the church before we can go out there and put that tent up in that parking lot. We got to get the church revived. And I'm proud of you, because we're doing good. We're doing gooder. And it's about getting gooder and gooder and gooder for God. Are we there yet? We got to get there. We got to get there. God says, you know what? I am coming soon. I am coming to capture my people. I am coming to save you. But he also says in the Bible he's coming after that remnant. Are you in the remnant? See, God's big. The world's big. But when he speaks about a remnant, I don't want you to lose your faith this morning. I don't want you to doubt, say, I can't make that remnant. That's a lie straight from the pits of hell. That's a lie that the devil is putting on you this morning. Everybody reach down and pick your mat up. Now, realistically this morning, thinking in your mind, these guys that got up a while ago, that first guy I talked to right there, he might as well have left that mat laying there. Give me that mat back. Right? He should have left it there. Because you could tell he was no better when he got up than when he first got there. The other guy, the other brother that was there, he got excited. How excited are you today to know that God loves you? Amen?
Yes, amen.
Amen. You see, God is a working wonder in your life. I want you to realize something this morning, guys. There's a point here that I'm trying to get across. That God loves us so much, he doesn't want to see anything bad happen to you. He wants you to have a good life. He wants you to have a prosperous life. Do I mean money? No. I mean spiritually prosperous life. And God said he would supply our needs. Sometimes we scrape from payday to payday. Sometimes we have to scratch for something to eat. Sometimes we have to scratch to get gas put in the car. But you still are blessed.
Amen.
There is millions of people starving flat to death. We're so blessed. We're so favored by God today. We do. We have a church to come to. We have food to eat. You don't have food, come to us. We'll make sure you got food. You know what? This church will get you some food. But here's what I'm trying to say. I want to speak about spiritual food for a second. Spiritual food is something that we have to have. Spiritual food, it's our daily bread. All of you will have a drink of water within the next 24 hours. You got to have that. You got to supply the body. God says, I will give you your daily bread. Man, just think back about the Israelites. I mean, they roamed around. They roamed around, man, and wore their old shoes out. They just didn't know which way to go. They just roamed around and roamed around and roamed around. I'm sure God was going, whew. Don't laugh at them because he does that to us.
Oh, yeah.
My. They moaned and they groaned and they complained and they griped and they cried. I can just see these little old quail right now flying down to their hand reach. Right? They wanted meat. God sent the quails in where they could just go and pluck them out of the air.
That's right.
Who could do that besides God? Nobody can do that. If any of you can go out there and catch a bird in this yard today. Not a dead one, brother. Yeah, oh. Not a dead one, a live one. Only God can do things like that. God is ready to work a miracle in your life today. You got your mat with you? I want you to fold it up and I want you to put it in your Bible. I want you to put it in the 5th chapter of John, okay? Anywhere in the 5th chapter of John. When you get home later on today, the next time you go to study, and I hope that's later on today or in the morning, I want you to write today's date on there. I want you to write, pick up your mat on that. The next time you start getting a little bit down, I want you to open that Bible. I want you to take that mat out, and I want you to hold it to the sky and say, Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm picking up my mat.
Amen.
Give the Lord a hand this morning. Amen. Let me close with this morning. And ye will not come to me that ye might have life. The only way we're going to have abundant life, my friends, is to give it to God. I preached a few weeks ago, let go and let God. If you wasn't here and you want a CD, let me know. I believe you would enjoy it. I believe that it would touch you. Let go of the things that's keeping you from serving God. And let God take control of your life.
Amen.
For the ones that don't know this, here a while back, a preacher come to me and he said, God's in control of everybody's life. I said, and I don't know if I can agree with that, brother. Because if that person doesn't agree to let God touch them, the prayer of a righteous man availeth much.
Amen.
You know that old song, Amazing Grace?
Yep.
Boy, boy, boy. If he saved a wretch like my wife's sister Sue, he'd save all. I mean, like me, he would save us all, right? God's good. Let's all stand. Are you glad you come to the house of the Lord today? This altar is open. This altar is open as I say the prayer today. If anyone would like to come forward, if you would like to dedicate your life, or how about rededicate your life? If you would like to give your problems to the Lord this morning, I ask that you step across the bloodline, that gold stripe right there. This is across the bloodline. I want to ask that you give them to God this morning, but I want you to do all of us a big favor. Leave it here.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
Don't turn around. Don't pick it up. In fact, don't even look back at it. When you walk away, it's gone. Amen? I hope you have your mats. I hope you picked up your mats. I hope you got them in your Bible today. The altar is open. Heavenly Father, in your Son's mighty name today, Lord, we thank you for the service that you give us today. We thank you for the point of being spiritually healed today. Now, Lord, we've all been done as mats in our life. But, Lord, we've picked them up. We're not going to be that mat. We're not going to be that doormat any longer. That mat is going to be my spiritual healing. Lord, as these mats are placed in your word today, Lord, let us be reminded of what we heard today. Lord, you've seen how your son touched that man and he just had one excuse after another, like he really didn't even care. But yet he got up. He didn't even really acknowledge you. He didn't thank you. He didn't hug you. He just got up and walked away. Lord, we want to be like that other brother was this morning. We want to be excited today that we know, that we know, that we know that God has touched our lives, Lord. And Lord, in all sincerity this morning, I know we've cut up and I know that we've laughed, Lord, but it's serious stuff right now, Lord. God, touch these people that's come up here this morning. I ask for a touch for every single person in the building today, Lord. I ask that you touch every family represented here of every person in here, Lord. Lord, have your way. Have your will from now on in my life. Lord, I've picked up my mat. I have given this mat to you. Lord, help me to be that person that I need to be. Lord, help me to be a Paul. Lord, help me to be a Job. Lord, help me to be like the people of the Bible. Lord, help me to be like your son was. Lord, all this is glory to you today. Father, it's not about me. It's not about anybody in this church. It's all about you today. Lord, we thank you for this Sabbath day. We thank you for this holy day. We thank you for this rest day. And Lord, we know that you're a miracle-working God. Lord, you see the people that is down here right now at this altar. Touch them, Lord, in a very, very special way. I ask that you would release their problems. Release their issues, Lord. Let them realize, Lord, how much you love them. Father, help us to be all that we can be. Lord, don't let us leave this place today the same way that we was 2 hours ago. Lord, help us to be that new person. God, we may have the same old name. We may have the same old clothes. We may have the same old shoes on this day. But Heavenly Father, I ask in the name of Jesus that we're that new man now. We're that new woman. We're that new child. We're that new creature. Help us, Lord, to overcome all situations. The only way we can do that is by the power of your blood, Lord. Lord, you see your people on this side of the bloodline this morning, Lord. I am so thankful, so grateful this morning, Lord. But Lord, don't let them be discouraged when they leave this place today, Lord. Lord, don't let them run into the things that they used to do, Lord. Lord, I'm asking that you would keep them away from bad company, Lord. Lord, I'm asking that they know that they could pick up the phone anytime and call any of us in this church and we'll help them. We'll pray with them. We'll do what we got to do, Lord, to save their souls, Lord. Oh, Lord, help us, please, realize today that we know that you're coming soon. Soon and very soon, the song says, every knee shall bow, every ear shall hear, every tongue shall confess the name of Jesus, Lord. And Lord, that judgment line is coming, Lord. I want us all to be on the smiling side of that judgment line. I want us to be on that joyous side, that happy side, that peaceful side that we know without a shadow of a doubt that them gates is going to be open for us, Lord. The time has come. Listen to the song. Listen very carefully. That's what this altar is for. That's what this altar is for. At the altar this morning, I want to ask you not to leave. Please, please stay here. Before they close the doors. That doesn't mean that door right there. That means the doors to heaven. The Father. father is praying with his son.
Father kneels beside them, thanking God they've come.
If you literally have a dad today, or if you do not have a dad today, the father is the father. He's your father. He is with you today. He is on your side, believe me. Pray for your family. Hearts are being broken.
Lives are being changed.
Thank you, dear Lord, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.
Never be the same. The time has come to give in to the Lord.
That's what this altar is for.
That's what this altar is for.
Yes, it is. Please don't leave if you're up here.
You don't have to carry those burdens anymore.
Did you hear that? You do not have to carry them burdens anymore. Do not.
The Lord would have me to say to you, stop. Stop and quit taking things for granted. Yeah, we make excuses. He loves us. He cares about us. He heals us. He takes care of us. We can't do these things that we do without Him. I'll just thank God this morning. I love all of y'all.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
Go quickly before they close the door.
Before they close the door.
You can give your burdens to
the Lord. I want everybody that's up there this morning that truly wants a new life.
That's what
I want you to do. If you truly want that new life this morning that only God can give you,
right.
Only God can give you.
God is real. The devil tells us all the time, even though I've been in church almost 30 years, the devil, he's always messing with me and saying, that's all in your head. I know better. Here we are today because of God. It's nothing that Pastor Steve has done or Sister Sue has done, but it's taking the steps that God has wanted us to take. And the more that you take those steps, the closer you'll get to God. There's nothing in this world worth sending your soul to hell over. Nothing. And the devil is going to mess with you guys. He messes with you because that's his job. But, as I told them kids this morning in Sunday school, greater that's in me than he that's in this world. And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. We can go out and do all kind of things, but where does that take us?
The hell.
That's right. Most of these people, well, I won't say most of them. Sister Vi, come here. Sister Kay, come up here, baby. Brother Scotty, Brother Albert, get over here.
Over here?
Okay. Yeah, get over here where everybody can see y'all.
That's right. Come on, Brother Albert.
Come down.
Where do you want
me? Stand right up here.
I'm the shorty.
I come over here. There you go.
You're the short one.
Yeah, you're the short one. Come on. Yeah, well. Okay, come on, brother. On a serious note, these four people right here that I know personally, has lived a hellacious life.
Amen.
Sister Vi was a prostitute down on Simmons Drive.
Yep.
For many, many years, she was a prostitute.
Yep.
And I'm telling you, I know this for a fact, because I used to see her stroll down Simmons Drive, and I'd drive down and I'd pray, God, touch that woman. Touch her. Not my prayers, but what God's done for her. It's nothing about what Sister Sue has done, but I know what God can do.
Amen.
And this
Amen.
Is what he's done for Sister Vi. Yep. Now, when she first came into the church, how long ago? About 15, 16
from
years ago?
One.
From day one.
Well, from day one, basically,
day one.
Yeah. She was a little, and boy, I tell you,
oh, yeah.
She would get nose to nose with me and say all kind of things, but we won't even go there. But today, God has brought her to where she is. She's the assistant pastor's wife.
Amen.
Brother Scotty, when we met him, He was homeless. He had no home. Nothing. Nothing. And now today he's assistant pastor. Well, brother, that's right. There again. It's all God. But I'm just telling you this where you will know that God can bring you from the pits of hell to where these people are today.
I remember when I said, like the song, he can save a wretch like me.
That's right. That's right. Sister Kay, well, she's had her journey too. Well, even Sister Barbara. Yeah, she's another one. Brother Albert, well, we could take all day there, bro. But anyway, in other words, he's looked out behind bars before several years, huh, Brother Albert? But look where God has brought him from. So you can't tell me that God can't take the person that nobody thinks is ever going to be anything and change them, because here's four of them right here. There are five of them that I know for sure that God has touched and changed their lives. So what we're going to do for the ones that truly, truly want your lives changed, we're going to pray a repentance prayer.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to tell everybody, it's not easy to serve God because the world is so tempting. He tempts me every day. Now, I'm going to tell this little story, then we're going to pray. I never will forget, I was probably saved probably 20 years at the time. It was hot, hot, hot one summer. It was so hot. And I had stopped at a little convenience store out on 62 and I-10 to get me a Coke. I walked in there and they had a thing out there. It was a, what would you call it? Yeah, a display. And it was full of beers in there. And they had this pitcher and it was tipped over like this and it was pouring in that glass. The devil said, Sue, you ain't never had no beer, so here, get you one. Nobody will never know the difference. I'm like, that's probably true, but God would. So, you see, God, I mean, the devil even tempts me as long as I've been in church. So remember, the temptation will always be there. But as I said, greater that's in me than he that's in this world, and I can overcome. But here's the thing, guys, you've got to keep pushing. You have to push. Like Pastor said earlier, God is not going to push himself on you. If you don't want it, that's your call. But you can't run around with bad people. You know the old saying, like I told them kids this morning, you become what you run with. You run with the bad, it's going to run off. And like I told them, it's easier to be bad than it is to be good. Come on. It really is. It's really easier to cuss somebody than to witness to them, isn't it? We've all been there. But remember the rewards that God. I know for a fact how good God is, because he's brought Pastor and I from nothing to where we are today. We had $10 when we married. $10. We paid the preacher $5. This is the God's honest truth. We paid the preacher $5 to marry us, and we had $5 left. But God said, you know what? If you will follow me, I will open up the windows of heaven, and you can hold the blessings that I will give you. And that very thing has happened to us. But anyway, we're going to pray a repentance prayer, okay, brother? Yes, ma'am.
And also, this is what I found out, the more you work your way toward your spiritual walk, don't get discouraged, because I have several times, because the devil's going to fight you.
Yes, ma'am. That's right. God is always there. We just got to be open to the Lord. Lord, what is it that you want me to do?
Yes.
Amen. Ooh. Amen. All right. You want to pray it, brother, or you want me to?
Well, that you pray, just get them, just everybody to repeat after
y'all me. Repeat after me, okay? First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to pray this little prayer, then we're going to repeat. I'll tell you when. Father God, I just thank you for the ones that has come up to this altar. Lord God, I'm asking you, Lord, that you would begin to open up the hearts of these people, Lord, like never before. Lord, you told us that if we would go out into the highways and the byways, that you would call them in. And this is something, Father, that you've done. So, Lord God, now it's in their hands and it's in your hands, Lord. Father God, we're asking you right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, that you would touch each and every one of these people, Lord. As we say this repentance prayer, we're asking you, Lord, that you would help them from this moment on. Not to look back, not to look forward, but just take today for today only. Because, Father, we're not guaranteed tomorrow. And yesterday, we can't do anything about it. It's gone. It's over with. It's it. But, Lord, we can live for you. So, Father, I'm asking you, Lord, that you would help us. So I want you guys to repeat this. Heavenly Father,
Heavenly Father,
I'm sorry for all the things that I've done in the past.
I'm asking you, Lord,
from this moment on,
that I'll never look back.
I'll never turn back. Now, Lord, I need your strength.
I need your wisdom.
I need your understanding.
I need your guidance.
Lord, give me a hunger
for your word
like I've never had.
And Lord,
from this moment on, I'm going to stand and I'm going to do what you've called me to do. And Lord,
when I leave this place,
let me be a witness
to this world.
And Lord, help me to realize
that the devil
is always going to tempt me.
But greater that's in me
than he that's in this world.
And I can do all things
through Christ
who strengthens me.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.